Lily, happy birthday. Great big celebration here for the 100th birthday. I was just reading last night that there are only 32,000 people who've reached 100 years of age in the U.S. right now, so that's incredibly exciting. Just have a special video here so that all of your friends can find out that during your 100 years, where you've probably met so many people, done so many things, but that you've had this incredible secret life of advising a diverse group of famous and quasi-famous people, ranging from politics to sports to TV journalism. For example, I ran into David Gregory, who up until just recently was the moderator and host of Meet the Press. And he has a few words to say to you.
Hey Lily, happy birthday. What a milestone, 100 years. I hope it's a great day. And I want to thank you for all the great advice you gave me every week before Meet the Press. You really did have great insights.
Then recently I was in Washington, D.C. and came across the fact that you advised Ted Koppel, who was the host of Nightline for many, many years. Ted had some incredible things to say about you. For example,
Lily, you minx. Where were you when you were only a nubile 90 and I was still only 65? We could have made such beautiful music together, but now I'm afraid I'm too old for you. In any event, happy, happy birthday, my dear. I still resonate to the advice you gave me on some of those memorable nightlines. They wouldn't have been as great without you, and you wouldn't be as great if you hadn't made it this far. 100 and still raring to go. Love you, Lily. Happy birthday.
And then I was even more amazed, because I know you were, and everyone should know, you were a great golfer. You love sports. You took me to my first baseball games. But I was amazed that you were involved with Sugar Ray Leonard, the boxing champion for many years. And Sugar Ray just is glowing in his praise of all the things you did for him.
Hey, Lily. How you doing? You may not remember me. I'm Sugar Ray Leonard. I mean, we go way back, about 100 years. I heard it's your birthday. I want to wish you a happy birthday. And I want to thank you for all the advice you gave me on some of my most important fights, biggest fights in my career against Marvelous Marvin Hagler. You told me exactly what to do against Tommy the Hitman Hearns. You gave me the perfect advice to beat that guy. And you gave me the advice on how to make Roberto Duran quit. The No Mas fight, remember that? Anyway, I'm not going to waste your time. No more about me. I want to say happy birthday. Happy 100th birthday. And that's pretty cool. By the way, your son, Alan, he made this happen. So kudos to you guys and love you. Happy birthday.
And then, even more amazing to me, is the basketball commentator, Dick Vitale, who has been on ESPN for many, many years. Dick actually is involved and lives in your neighborhood, but he had just incredible praise about all of the help you've given him during his career.
Hi, Lily. How's my pal doing? 100 years old. Happy birthday. Hey, Lily, where would I be without all your advice over the years? All those questions I used to ask you about basketball and how without you, there's no way I would have ever gotten in the Hall of Fame. Lily, you're a Hall of Famer. You're solid gold, and you're going to go for another 100, baby. Lots of luck. God bless. And you're awesome, baby, with a capital A.
We've talked about how you've been involved in TV journalism, a little bit of sports, but what I didn't know is that you've advised a lot of important people in the political arena. For example, James Carville, who many of you probably aware is a TV commentator, but was famous for creating the war room for Bill Clinton in his 92 and 96 successful presidential elections, was really kind and sort of opened up to me and told me all about what you did with him and the Clinton campaign.
Well, my goodness, this is your friend James Carville right here. just remembering all the great advice you gave me in 1992 and 1996 and all during the Clinton presidency, my God, we couldn't have had the peace and the prosperity we had in the 90s without you. And now it's your 100th birthday. And I'm just so happy to join in and wish you the very best. And I know that President Clinton and the entire Clinton administration appreciates the wise counsel and the insight and the wisdom that you provided. Happy 100th birthday.
The most amazing piece of all of this is I know you've been a lifelong Democrat. So I was really amazed during my research to find out that you've given tremendous advice to a few Republicans. And the one that's really amazing to me is Sarah Palin. And I really can't believe this, but Sarah got in touch with me and wanted to wish you birthday wishes.
Hi, Lily. It's Sarah Palin, way up here in Alaska, wishing you a very, very, very happy 100th birthday. And Lily, this is such a milestone, and so deservedly so. I really, really admire you and all that you've accomplished, especially those accomplishments that you've shared with me and advised me as I was mayor of this wonderful city, Wasilla, Alaska. And then as I ran for vice president, I am thankful for you. And I want to thank you today for taking my phone calls and giving me all that advice. In fact, the best advice I ever got was from you. And anything that I did right in my campaigns and in my offices in which I served is thanks to you, Lily. So God bless you. Many, many more birthdays. Have a blast on your 100th birthday.
So this is quite amazing. I'm sure if I spent more time at it, I would find many, many other famous and not so famous people who have been blessed in their lives because of all the help you've given them. Certainly, I'm blessed, my sister Nancy's blessed, and all your friends are blessed who have known you. And tremendous great wishes for your 100th birthday, but I just thought it was really important for all your friends here tonight to know that you've had this secret life and makes it even that much more interesting to say you know Lillian Meckler.
You ain't seen nothing yet. The best is yet to come, and babe, won't it be fine? Best is yet to come, come the day you're mine. Come the day you're mine. I'm gonna teach you to fly. We've only tasted the wine.